your hat and leave.
Sure, I'll leave.
Ah, thank you, sir.
But it seems to me with all this chivalry that's being paraded around here, you might at least let me explain my side of the story. I've never stood for so much abuse from anybody.
If I didn't consider it unbecoming my years, you'd stand abuse of a different kind.
No, sir, I wouldn't. If it wasn't for your years, you never would get away with what you've already said.
Michael, you go now and let me talk to
if
you.
If he doesn't go, I'll put him out.
Daddy.
Norma, I'm not holding you blameless. But you haven't the slightest idea what's in this fellow's mind. And you can thank God you have a father to protect you.
You won't need a protector when we're married.
Michael.
My daughter will never marry you, nor any trash like you. Now, the sooner you get that through your head and get out of here, the better it's going to be for everyone concerned.
Daddy, please, will
you get out of the room
something?
Now, or you don't understand.
She understands more than you do. I was going to ask you to let us marry, but I see there's no use of that, so I'm telling you, understand?
Hold your tongue, sir.
Daddy!
Get out of my way. Now, you impudent scoundrel, get out of this town.
Oh, so you in the town too, do you? I'll get out of this town when I please, and I'll take her with me.
I'll get my things, Norman, come back for you. We'll go to my cousin.
If there was anything of the gentleman about
oh,
you,
shut
sir,
up, you damn you hypocrite!
Sir!
I'll kill him, I'll do it enough. Standing around beating your head off when I'm trying to do what's right.
Get out! Get out!
Listen! If you would shut your mouth for a while and try to find out what happened last night, you wouldn't be so damned afraid I'd marry her.
Michael, stop!
Where do you suppose she was until 4 o'clock this morning? Where do you suppose she spent the night? In my cabin, alone with me, the whole town knows about it. Why, you old fool, you ought to be begging me to marry her. I've been trying to do the right thing, trying to protect your daughter's name, but you won't let me. So I'll marry her and protect her in spite of you. I'll come back this afternoon for you, Norma.
Oh, Daddy, dear. He didn't know he lost his
head. Be quiet. Julia!
Daddy, what?
Of course, I don't have to be told what he said about last night isn't true. Norma!
No, Daddy, no!
Julia, I want you to take Miss Norma to her room and keep her there.
I won't go! Daddy!
I heard Norma call as I was coming up. Is there anything wrong?
Yes, Stanley. Something damnably wrong. But I'm going to rectify it.
Dr. Besant, you know.
Hand aside.
Is it my
hand aside, sir?
I won't go to my room. I won't. I'm too old to be locked up. Damn it, where's Daddy? What's
it's
he going to do?
Nothing, honey. It's...
What's he going to do?
It's all right, dear. Just wait here a minute.
Jerry, Stanley, what?
Come like the devil. The shortcut to Michael's cabin. Tell us to keep out of sight.
Michael?
Your father will kill him if you don't.
Hey!